Hi guys, welcome back to What Likes My Cat, it's Claire and Rags, and this week we're going to be telling you how you can treat minor injuries and sickness whilst the vets are closed. Now at the moment, obviously a lot of vet practices are actually closed, though they are still available on the phone. Rags and I have a few tips for you on basic cat first aid and treatment for things that may not need the vet that you can do at home. Now I actually have a certificate in feline first aid and care, so I'm just going to share with you a few things that you can do at home if your cat gets any minor injuries or sickness. First of all is bleeding. So if they have a bleeding wound or they cut themselves, first of all you need to do is make sure that your cat is calm. Now don't go making a big fuss or being afraid around your cat, they'll pick up on this and that this will stress them out. Stem any bleeding with a tightly wound bandage. Obviously if it's around its neck, don't tie it too tight, you want it to be able to breathe. If you have anything like non-stick dressing, now put the dressing onto the wound. Put a bit of cotton wool on top of that and then wrap a bandage tightly around it. If the bleeding doesn't stop or your cat seems to lose consciousness or it changes in any way, do ring your vet. It might be an emergency and they might need to get sent in to be looked at by a vet. Next is broken bones. If your cat has broken a bone or their tail, don't try to put a splint on it or wrap it in any bandages. This might cause more pain and more damage. If there's any bleeding, deal with that with how I said before and ring your vet. Broken bones are considered an emergency and they will need to be seen by a vet. The next is burns and scalds. Now if your cat has a minor burn or a minor scald, make sure that you run the affected area under cold water for at least 5 minutes. Now it is important to make sure that you remember not to put any ointments or creams on cats. Most of these things that you'll have in your house are for human use and are no good for cats. The next is fits and seizures. Now, some cats have underlying conditions which mean they have fits and seizures on a regular basis. So if you have a cat who's like that, you're probably well versed in this anyway. But if you're not, make sure that you don't try and hold your cat if they're having a fit. Put your cat somewhere that is dark and quiet and away from anything that's going to harm them. So make sure they're not on a table or on a high chair or anywhere high up, or there's nothing around them that's sharp or dangerous where they might hurt themselves on it while they're having a fit. If you are very, very worried about your cat, it keeps having seizures or the seizures aren't ending, do call your vet. This is an emergency. Next is heat stroke. Now this is quite rare, but can happen to cats if they get trapped somewhere which is quite hot, especially in the summer months. If this happens, wet your cat's coat with some tepid water and make sure that you keep them somewhere that is cool and safe. And finally, if your cat gets stung by anything, especially in the summer months, there's a lot of stingy little insects. Now, make sure if it's a sting that's actually still in your cat, make sure that you locate it and remove it. If your cat gets stung by a bee, add a solution of bicarbonate of soda, that'll help remove the sting. And if they've been stung by a wasp, put some diluted vinegar on the sting. Apply ice to reduce the heat and the swelling, and once you've got the sting out, just keep an eye on them to make sure that they're okay. Thanks for watching guys, I hope you did enjoy this video and I hope that you don't have to use these, but hopefully they will be helpful if you do. Now if you did enjoy the video guys, please give us a big thumbs up, it helps the channel out loads, and if you've not subscribed already, just hit the button in the middle there, and while you're at it, head on over to the other side of the screen to the vlog from last week and give that a bit of love as well. Thanks again for watching, hope you guys are staying safe, and Rexy and I will see you in our next video. Bye!